Said I'm going to be taking you through this home here today. You're standing in front of what's truly considered to be the very best example in the United States of America of a private home that's built in Gothic Revival architecture. Gothic, you know, Europe hundreds of years ago, Spain, France, Italy, whatever, that's what we've got here. Designed by an architect called Alexander Jackson Davis, A.J. Davis. Designed for the mayor of New York City back in the 1840s. Mayor is looking for a little place up in the river here and get out of that ugly, dirty, smelly, disease-infested tuberculosis city. He bought about 50 acres of land up here in Westchester, hired A.J. Davis to build him a little retirement home. One of the reasons we take you out here on the lawn is because this is not the home. You gotta get rid of half of it. The wraparound porch, take it away, it wasn't here. The piece that sticks out front, that's called the porte cochere. That's where you got out of your buggies, it wasn't here. The roof line. Lowered about 8 bricks on the southern part of the house. And most important, the big tower there. And all the rooms north of the tower. Take them all away. What's left is a little house that Mayor Paulding had built for him by Alexander Jackson Davis in the 1840s in the midst of about 50 or 60 acres of grazing and farming.
Today, you will see how each generation left its mark on the estate. You'll hear much about the Rockefeller generations on your tour, so here's a brief historical snapshot to help you put it all into context. The first resident at Kikuit was John D. Rockefeller, the founder of Standard Oil and the person generally considered to be the inventor of modern philanthropy.
Acres. Now what I'm going to do is ask you to go back in time to envision what this place looked like. Zero. Nothing is here. Everything that you're going to see today is man-made. Like all the landscape is man-made because this was just a hill. A barren hill. Very, very rural. And the other unique historical home. It gives tours, but we only give tours 6 months out of the year. The 12 months out of the year we have conferences. And these apartments above, which were originally the apartments for the people who worked here, who took care of the horses, the grounds, et cetera, et cetera.
Putting on the rigs, putting on the rigs.
Watch your step. There's one step down here. After you finish.
Watch your step.
So Laura, you're The section on the right-hand side was built by Frederick Philip I about 1680, and his son Otto Phillips and this section over here about 1730. You see a line going down the middle. That shows you the important part of the Phillips family on Pearl Street, and they also had a manor 1730. He was 84 years old when he died, but accomplished in 1715. He had never married, didn't have any children.
Thank you.
didn't bother to bring them on. I thought, well, you know.
And my high top shoes and my hair piled high upon my head, I went to lose a jolly hour on the trolley and lost my heart instead. With this light brown derby and this bright green tie, he was quite the handsomest of men. I started to yen, so I counted to ten, then I counted to ten again. Trolley, ding, ding, ding went the bell. Sing, sing, sing went my heartstrings. From the moment I saw it, I fell. Chug, chug, chug went the motor. Bump, bump, bump went the brake. Thump, thump, thump went my heartstrings. When he smiled, I could feel the car shake. He picked his hat and took said he hoped he hadn't stepped upon my feet. He asked my name, I held my breath. I couldn't speak because he scared me half to death. Buzz, buzz, buzz went the buzzer. Bop, bop, bop went the wheels. Stop, stop, stop went my heartstrings. As he started to go, then I started to know how it feels when the universe
the day was bright, the air was sweet. The smell of honeysuckle charmed you off your feet. You tried to sing, but couldn't speak. In fact, you loved it so you couldn't even speak.
Buzz, buzz, buzz went the buzzer. Pop, pop, pop went the wheel. Stop, stop, stop went my heart thrill.
Okay.
Started to leave, I could hold up his sleeve with my hand.
Into a railroad gondola, creating yachts, tugs, and barges such as the ones we'll see up ahead. Now, the Rondell Harbor was also the home of the Cornell Steamboat Company, which at its peak had over 60 vessels operating in the river, and at that time it was the largest steamboat company in the country. Now, just up ahead on the right, you'll see a barge graveyard. Now, those barges were abandoned there about 70 years ago when they were no longer needed for work in the river. So they were just pushed up into the shallow water there and left to rot away. Now, the narrowest one, just off to the right now, is an old D&H Canal barge. And the D&H Canal, Delaware Hudson Canal, was an engineering feat of pre-industrial America. It was conceived in 1823 by William and Maurice Hertz, two Philadelphia dry good merchants. Now, they hired Benjamin Wright, who was the chief engineer of the newly created 350-mile Erie Canal, to survey and design the canal from the coal fields in Pennsylvania here to the Hudson. Now, the canal was 4 feet deep, 32 feet wide, and contained 108 locks, 137 bridges, 26 basins, dams, and reservoirs, and cost an estimated $1.2 million to build. Now, construction for the canal lasted from 1825 up until 1898. And on the left, construction for that one started in 1913, and it was first built on August 25th of 1915. Now, for most of its... gave the property to the federal government. Now, the mansion was declared a National Historic Site on December 18th of 1940.
If you want to move in, you have to have a my sandy suit hat does not reflect that yet. Anyway, follow me into the chapel, please.
This is upstate New York, which has seen no war or combat since the American Revolution. But in the skies over this farmland, a Fokker triplane and a Sopwith pup engage in a mock dogfight every Sunday afternoon during the spring, summer, and fall. Two of the airplane's most colorful era. Old Rhinebeck boasts a superb collection of vintage aircraft, a squadron of priceless museum pieces, out of the past but very much a part of today. For they're not motionless, grounded antiques, content to rest on their laurels. At Rhinebeck, they take to the air, making history a living, breathing reality. New Jenny could fly only 70 miles an hour, and it had to climb over 6,000 feet to reach that top speed.